Hello people of YouTube, my name is Brad, this is my channel, Anime Orange, and welcome to part 2 of the Iconics Hogwarts Express build that we have right here. In part 1, we worked on a lot of the underside chassis part, we worked on some wheels, got some things prepped and ready. In this part, part 2, we'll start building the rest of the model, bringing it all together. So let's pick up where we left off last time. We had just gotten the majority of this undersection finished. And let's pick up and go from there. I'm still working out the usefulness of these tapers that I 3D printed. They are helpful, but not perfectly so. made the mistake of bending the tabs on part 60 inward, which put them partially over the slot for the next part. The tabs for part 57 were then pushed up when I put the other assembly on, and I had to push apart the tabs and then push them back down in opposite direction. I ran into a paint clog. I had to poke this slot clear. I ran into the same sort of issue with the logging truck and trailer build. Not a big deal, but be good to look ahead before you start putting parts together to make sure the slots are open. There was a little bit of a struggle to figure out the best way to attach this part with its curve. I found that curving the side of the tank way inward did the trick. Also, I ended up taking off all of the finger cots, save for the one over my recently cut thumb, because they kept catching on the tabs and preventing me from lining up tabs and slots. To secure the tabs, I basically pushed them over and down. More paint-covered slots. Thank you. I almost put one of the tabs of part 70 in the wrong slot because the correct slot was mostly covered by paint. Actually, for a bit, I thought the hole was misstamped until I probed the area where the slot was supposed to be and pushed paint out of the way, discovering the slot. For part 18, I put 72 on the wrong side of 73. To bend the tabs down on the delicate part 81, I needed to hold the main part with the flat nose pliers and push the tabs down with my fingers or other tool. Part of step 19 has you make this chain. I do not know the purpose of it. Each end of it has a slight gap that you use to hook the end parts on, then slightly pinch that open area closed. I realized here that I had put this side piece together upside down. Time to fix that mistake. When putting the roof on, the side tabs did not want to go into its slots, so I gave them a little bit of an outward bend. Worked like a charm. For part 91, I initially tried to bend down the tabs holding the curved sides rather than twist them. Without support, it just wasn't working. After I attached part 91 to 90, I was able to fold over the tabs. Also, I almost forgot to add part 92 on top of part 91. And now I just realized I missed adding part 92.
another paint plugged hole. The curved section did not curve smoothly, so I made some adjustments with the tips of the tweezers. Repeat to make two. I used one of the ends of the dome shaping tool to work a curve around the edge of part 96. This is another situation where I held the part with the tool because it was so thin, and pushed the tabs over with my fingers. I almost forgot to bend the bottom edge up on both of these side parts. There's not really a fold line, and the bend is stiff. Also, I bent a little side piece the wrong way on one part. In step 25, for parts 109, I just went ahead and twisted the tabs holding the thin side strips down. Since these pieces do not attach to a larger part giving it more support, I did not have an effective way to fold over the tabs. I decided to bend the two tabs for the tank inward a bit to help them into their slots. It worked so well that after I secured the rear tabs, I found the two tabs for the tank were already in their spot. I was trying to line up the round front section when I realized a mistake that I had made. The chain thing on the rear had fallen into the frame of the train as I was putting the two halves together, and I needed to get it out. What a pain. I loosened enough tabs to free it, and then was able to get all but one of those tabs back into place. The one that didn't go back folded over, and you really don't notice it because there's a tab right beside it that holds things together nonetheless. I could not see to line up the tabs on the sides, so I pulled off one of the side pieces. There are two tabs over here, but one of them folded inward. The other went into its slot, and I felt that that was enough. With all the handling, one of the tabs slipped out. Getting on part 113 was tedious. I tried to twist the tab somewhat lightly so as not to damage or twist the rails. It wasn't enough, and this part fell off later, and I had to try again. Starting from the front was maybe not the way to go. And there it goes. I didn't like how the curve on the front section didn't exactly match the sides. I tried to push the curve down a bit more, which helped, but only so much. If I could go back and start again, I would have made more of a point to bend the front of part 29 down at a sharp angle initially, then curve the rest. Probably would have matched that curve better. This chain is like the one earlier in the build that has a gap you slide over to connect it to two pieces, then pinch the gap close. I nearly forgot to attach the tabs at the rear here.
And that's it. It is all finished and complete. I've kept showing you this at the beginning of the videos. This is what you end up with. This is a very sizable model. It took a grand total of 6 hours and 50 minutes to put this entire model together. It has quite a bit of detail in it and some rather large parts. It had some challenging areas, but not overly so. And I want to take a moment to show you in comparison to the little bitty Metal Earth version, which has a cold car in the back, but I'm not holding that up right now. You can kind of see the size difference between the two. This is quite a bit bigger with a lot more detail. And oddly enough, while I was putting together this video, the in color version, BAMS exclusive, Books A Million exclusive, came in the mail. So hopefully I'll be doing that soon. But anyway, I'll leave it at that. The review is coming up very soon if it's not out already. Thank you for watching. As always, keep on keeping on.